This video demonstrates getting started with the ServiceNow Field Service mobile app to manage field service tasks. Link time codes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. Field service technicians and agents can use the Field Service mobile app to manage field service tasks starting with the Madrid release. Your administrator enables the Field Service mobile application by activating the Field Service Management plugin. All you need to do to get started is download the ServiceNow Agent mobile app from the Apple App Store or Google Play Store, open the app and add your instance, and log into your instance. Then tap on the app to launch it. In our example, we're logged in as a field service technician, ready to head out for the day's field work. Here's our schedule for today and tomorrow. The dot indicates that something's scheduled for that day. We receive a notification that a new task is in our queue. We can swipe down to view and access it, or view it in the notifications list. New assigned tasks appear here in My Tasks. We can swipe left and tap to accept or reject the task assignment right from the list, or we can open the record and access these options from the menu. Let's accept the task and review the activity on it, as well as the related lists. This task requires a router cooling fan. In the part record, we can find the part. A map opens, showing the location and number of parts available. And it's our lucky day. We have the part in our own stockroom. If that wasn't the case, we'd need to source the part. Here we'd select the stockroom we need it sent to and the quantity. Now let's view our task map, which displays all of our scheduled tasks. We can optimize today's route by selecting the option here. We can also check for knowledge articles related to the task and collaborate with our dispatcher and other team members via Connect. In our example, we want to check with our dispatcher about internet access at the task site before we head out. If you know that you won't have internet access at a site or are in doubt, you can prepare ahead of time to go into offline mode. To enable offline mode, we first need to download data while we still have internet access. We could go offline now, but let's wait until we get to the job site. When we arrive, we switch to offline mode. Some functionality becomes unavailable, but we can still access our tasks, inventory, and parts requirements. When we start the job, we select Start Work in the task menu, which changes the state to Work in Progress. The yellow outline indicates that this field was changed while we were offline. We need to record the parts we use and those that we remove during the job. We used one of these to replace the old fan. And we select Remove Part to remove the part we replaced. Note that you can use the barcode scanner to easily identify the correct asset. We need to record the time worked on this task, so we enter it here. We completed the task, so we close it and enter comments. Now we open the parent work order so we can capture our customer's signature to confirm that the job is complete. When we have internet access again, we can go back online and sync up the changes we made to the record. For more information, please see our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.